This is University of Nairobi, Kisumu Campus, School of Law. For this video clip, I would like most importantly to begin by giving you a wider introduction about the role of law in the administrative action. We know the definition of the administrative law is given as a set of rules and principles and regulations that govern the administrative agencies in whatever they do. Now, these administrative agencies of the government, they make decisions, they make rules, they come up with decisions that can affect certain individuals. And those decisions can affect the individuals either positively or negatively. If negatively, we refer to them as administrative wrongs that can also bring some disputes or complaints that may end up in tribunal. The decision made by the tribunal can as well be challenged in the court of law or the court of justice under the judicial kind of review. In this kind of review, the justice system will look into the details and the entire body of the judgment, if that judgment was done without violating or infringing on the rights of that individual. But most importantly, this first module will continue with other modules. I invite you to keep on watching us, and I ask you to subscribe to this YouTube channel. I would like to give you a historical demonstration of how the administrative action comes into what it is. We may go back in time up to the time of the ancient Greek. The ancient Greek people, they came up with a very, very powerful system. Their powerful system that ended up in becoming an explosive empire in the classic period, in the ancient time, was based on Hellenistic culture. And that was a strong culture of the Greek people. So they were using arts and their geniality at that time to conquer other nations. This one lasted quite a long period of conquest by the Greeks. And after the Greeks, we had the Roman Empire. The Romans managed to conquer nations not only by using weapons and arms and their military, but they conquered populations by using their legal system. And that is the administrative law. We know of the Justinian Court, which codified the Roman law, and the Romans imposed their law on the conquered populations. We know the history very well. It lasted very long, and after which another empire that became very, very powerful was the time of colonization, and this was by the British. But going back in time, after the classic period and neoclassic period, we get to the feudalism in the middle-aged Europe. That's the medieval time. Now, feudalism was a society based on the social relationship in which land became an issue. The feudal or the powerful man was the owner of the land. His slaves or those who were working for him were known as the serfs that he could buy on the market. That one passed, the time passed, and the time came during the period known as medieval time or the modern period, in which now enlightenment emerged. People are becoming more rational, a lot of studies. People are becoming more concerned with the management of any given state. During that time, we get to the 19th century early and 20th century at another level of understanding, in which I would like to talk about the 28th president of the United States of America by the name Thomas Wilson Woodrow. President Woodrow was a full and accomplished scholar and academic, as well as a politician. He achieved so much, but one of the things, the major achievements, which he left as a legacy, not only for the United States of America, but for the entire world, is the definition of the administrative law. Woodrow, in his published article, defined administrative law as government in action, because it is through the policies, the regulations and decisions that the government of the day makes that will now build up the administrative law. Talking about administrative law, my dear viewers, we are talking about a major component of public law apart from the constitutional law and the criminal law. The administrative law holds a very, very wide component. It includes every component concerning law, and that's the constitution, the statutes, the legal notices, and also the decisions made in a body of formulated or policy framework. Now, this policy framework or whatever comes as the government in action cannot work so well unless we address ourselves to the meaning or what we call the elements of administrative law that are captured in this book. So as introduction, we find that administrative law does not only require us to think in a narrow sense of the meaning of law, in the sense of a body of law formulated as the Act of Parliament, but in this case in Kenya we don't have administrative act. What we have so far is the Constitution of the Republic of Kenya. The Constitution being the supreme law or the fundamental law of the land gives powers to different organs of the state and different branches or arms of government. This is again for the better functionality of the state and of the government, so that the state and the government can achieve its higher goals in terms of the principles and values. And this is done in a way that will capture the legal system, the legal structure, and also the law reform. So as the society gets more complex and as many people, the population grows, many people come on board, and Kenya is now even in relationship with other nations and other parts of the world, including multinationals, a requirement of having a proper and an appropriate legal system known as administrative law is right now. The time has come, and the scholars are working around the clock to come up with an administrative system that will define the Kenyan system parting from the history. So Kenya is a young nation, as many other African countries, but we need to know one historical factor. Kenya adopts and adapts its administrative system from the former colonial power, that is the British. So at the time of independence in 1963, Kenya was struggling to come up with a system that would define itself within the culture of the Kenyan people, within the mentality, the traditions, and most importantly also the political nature of Kenya as it is today. So in the next series, we'll be taking you through how Kenya has been managing it with the new enactment of laws and amendments and changes, a new jurisprudence coming up very strongly, and again, most importantly, the case law that defines it all. Thank you for watching.